Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Rich Girls Online podcast. Today, we're going to be talking about how to build self-esteem and self-love. Self-esteem really comes down to how you view yourself and the regards in which you hold yourself. And self-love, I've always said, is an action word. Self-love is a verb. Self-love are daily practices that you do to love yourself, to take care of yourself, both physically and mentally. Self-loves are things which allow you to build your spirit, maintain your joy, and maintain your peace. Self-esteem and self-love are very important because when you have low self-esteem or there's a lack of self-love in your life, this will often reflect in the types of people and relationships which you will attract in your life. When you have low self-esteem and when you don't have self-love, you're going to attract people who don't value you, people who are out there to use you. You might find yourself degrading yourself in order for the betterment of others. When you do have self-esteem, when you put yourself on a pedestal, when you think highly of yourself, when you are the main character in your own life, when you love on yourself, when you embrace your self-care rituals, when you take time, when you spend on yourself, when you invest time into yourself, into your soul, into your emotions, into your mind, into your body, you're similarly also going to attract the right people who are going to want to give, who are going to want to pour into you, who are going to want to invest good things into you, because all things in this life are our mirror. Our relationships, the situations we attract, they simply mirror our inner state. And the sad part of this whole thing is that, you know, in school, we learn about math, we learn about sciences, we learn about literature, we learn about world history, but we don't really learn to love ourselves. We don't learn how to be confident. We don't learn how to value ourselves. We don't even learn our value. But conversations like these can really transform your life. It can transform the vision of the future and the vision you have of yourself in the future. When you have high self-esteem, you aspire higher. You don't doubt yourself as much, and you think, you know, that if anyone can do it, so can I. Building self-esteem really comes down to becoming the main character in your own life. Realizing that this is my story and taking ownership of that. Becoming the architect of your dreams, your goals, your vision. Stop letting other people make you the side character in their own missions and journeys. Stop letting other people dictate to you what you can and can't accomplish. Stop letting other people become the master to your own journey. Having self-esteem is all about stepping into your power, stepping into your voice, and realizing that I am the royalty here. In this life, in this experience that I'm going to experience while I'm on this earth, I am royalty. I'm the one in control of my own journey. I'm the one shaping this entire thing. And when you really step into that realization, you start to actually understand how special you are. You have that power in your own life. So there's no way that you're not important. There's no way that you are not the most important thing in your own life. It's impossible. And because you're so important, it's essential to take care of yourself, to take care of your mind, to take care of your body, to protect and to maintain your peace. Because without your peace and without your spirit in a good state, it's going to be very, very difficult for you to be happy and enjoy life. Self-love is a verb. Self-love looks like eating healthy, going for a 10-minute walk each day, reading a book for 10 minutes before bed at night, investing into your appearance, get a hairbrush, maybe get your nails done, finally sitting down and creating a plan for that business or that hobby or that thing that you've always wanted to do, or that thing you used to enjoy doing when you were little. Finally sitting down to look at your schedule and make time for the things that you love. Making time and prioritizing your own happiness. Self-love isn't just a concept, it's an action. And they are actions that you should take often. Ever since we're young, we crave that love and approval from our family, from our mom and dad, from our friends. We crave that love from our romantic partners. But what I've come to realize is that the most valuable form of love, the most rejuvenating and the most life-changing source of love in this life is myself. It's the love that I give to myself in the small moments of mundane everyday life. It's the small decisions. I am the one person who I'm always with 24/7, 365, from when I was born until when I die. I can't get away from myself. So me loving myself is essential. It's crucial to my own happiness, because the validation and the comfort and the good feelings of all these other people loving me, it's great, but they're not always around to love me. I don't always have them to lean on every second of every day. And so in order to sustain my happiness and my peace and my spirit, I need to pour that love into myself. And nobody can ever take that away. No breakup, no falling out, nothing. I am in control of my own happiness and my own peace. That is such a beautiful thought that no one can take that away from me. And that is what self-love does. It gives you that inexhaustible source of light and energy and peace that nobody on this earth can take away. And self-love and self-esteem really go hand in hand, because when you have high self-esteem, you're going to love yourself more and you're going to do things that exhibit that love tangibly. When you value yourself and when you embrace the beauty and the power and the worthiness that is you, you're going to protect it at all costs. For me, my self-love and my self-esteem journey did not begin until I graduated college. I went so many years putting people above me, putting people on a pedestal, becoming the servant to everybody around me. I spent so many years valuing other people more than I valued myself. I spent so many years doubting myself, not taking care of myself. But if it was for somebody else, oh yeah, I'd do it perfectly. That was that lack of self-esteem within me. I spent so many years just glazing over that, you know? I was so good at studying, I was so good at sports, but I didn't have that self-esteem and that self-love that I really needed to step into the highest version of myself, to become truly successful, to achieve those higher dreams and goals and visions for myself. That all came after I began my journey to healing myself and to loving myself on an every single day basis. So it doesn't matter if you're 15 or you're 30 or you're 55 listening to this podcast, you are here for a reason. It is never too late. And if you don't have anything else in this world, if you don't have a dime or a dollar to your name, the one thing that you have is yourself. Yourself and your time. And so if you can take a little bit of that time and just pour some love into yourself every single day, just watch and see how everything in your life transforms. I promise you. I love you, but do you love you? And before, when I used to struggle a lot in relationships and meeting toxic partners and always ending up the giver in a relationship and never really having balanced relationships, you know, I always ended up in situations where I was used or I was constantly trying to prove my worth because deep down I didn't feel valuable. I had low self-esteem. I had low self-worth. And my relationships with people, both platonic and romantic, and even family, didn't get better until I repaired that relationship that I had with myself and the way that I saw myself and the way that I treated myself. It all started with me. And so if you're looking to be married or you want to be in a loving, healthy relationship, if you want to repair your relationships with your family, have better friend relationships, this video is for you too, okay? Because a lot of the issues in all relationships, they stem back to self-esteem and self-love issues. You are everything, and everything and everybody around you is your mirror. They don't change until you change. If this video helped you and you learned something, please like this video, share this video with someone you know, comment down below different topics for future podcasts and what you guys want to talk about here, and please subscribe and turn on your post notification bells. Thank you guys and have a wonderful day.
I love Bye. You. And I'll see you guys next time on the Rich Girls Online podcast.